Northeastern University was first established in 1896, a school for commuters and residents of the area. The nation was in the grips of the Great Depression, and students had just witnessed the formation of a College of Liberal Arts as an addition to existing programs in engineering and business. This was an addition to the construction and occupancy of a brand new building that stood as a symbol of the newly gained independence and said to the world, Northeastern University has arrived. Some would have predicted 10 new buildings or the enrollment of a few boarding students from distances like New Hampshire and Maine. But not one of these revelers would have possibly imagined the university that exists today.
In 1946, Northeastern celebrated its Golden Jubilee, with the Student Center being the first of many structures created during this building boom. Then, what was the Student Center was completed in 1946. It was primarily geared for students with classrooms on the upper levels, Blackman Auditorium on the first floor, and the Student Center on the ground floor. The Student Center was a room for commuters to relax and hang out in between their classes with a food stand, lockers, and a study area. In 1958, the Student Center was named Carl Stevens L. Student Center after the current president of the university and became a more centralized place for the students. After the Student Center was built, many other structures were created around it, including Hayden Hall, Dodge Hall, Richards Hall, and Herdick Hall. After realizing what they needed from their school, students at Northeastern demanded more of their center. However, Northeastern did not have the funds available to meet the students' expectations. They wanted to make this central part of campus not only for commuters, but for anyone involved in clubs, groups, and meetings. In addition to new student demands, the safety codes were outdated, giving the students an appropriate reason to propose for a build. In 1962, students formed the first referendum by taxing themselves $12.50 per quarter in order to bring the Student Center up to the present. After the referendum had been approved and Northeastern students raised the money, the L. Hall addition was built onto the original Student Center, and the original Student Center area became Northeastern's current bookstore. The center was now a much larger area with 5 floors. Encompassing the ground floor was a bookstore, information desk, cafeteria, and seating for the students to eat. The first floor, known as the indoor quad, was more of a lounge area for students. The second floor was mainly meant for student groups and club offices. Finally, the third and fourth floors were set aside for meeting rooms, offices, and a game room. From this expansion, students became much more involved at the university and showed their love for the school. This place became the living room of Northeastern. Some student groups and clubs that were formed during this time are still here today. The 1970s and 80s was a time of turbulence, and the world was not quite focused on schools, having more important issues to deal with, such as the Vietnam War. Minority groups were becoming less of a minority, and this brought a lot of diversity to the campus. The African American Institute was formed, followed by the Latino Cultural Center, the International Student Center, and the Asian American Center.
Hi, this is Michael Kozak. I'm standing right here in front of the Student Center. We're about to walk in today, and this is about the L Center renovation. Come on.
Northeastern continued to grow in size and diversity with many student groups, clubs, buildings, and organizations, which brought in a need for change. At this time, there was too much going on and not enough of an organized space for it on campus. In 1992, the 30-year mortgage was coming to a close and the Student Center was up for retirement. At this time, the Student Center had not been renovated since it was built. The fire and safety codes were outdated, and the center was worn down, looking similar to a cellar, as students would call it.
Your name is?
Stephanie Manson.
Stephanie. Okay, you're working up here in the student activities office. Why do you think we should renovate the student center?
I think that it's time for a change. It's been 30 years since the building's been built, and obviously the needs of the students are changing, so the building should change with those needs.
Do you want to see the student center renovated?
Better looking here.
Well, I think that this building is old enough and it needs a few. I mean, you take a look at any of the other colleges around and everything's so modern. This building looks pretty old.
Yeah. Do you know that this building was built in 1965 and hasn't changed a bit since?
Yes, I do.
Yes, you do. All right, all right. Now, have you voted yet for the Student Center renovation project?
Actually, I didn't vote, no.
You haven't voted. But if you were to vote, would you vote yes or no?
Yeah, I would.
Now, why would you vote yes?
I don't know. I think it could use bigger, better place, maybe.
Student life was growing rapidly, and as more and more events occurred, students recognized how much they needed a practical and more inviting student center. Students proposed a new renovation plan to President Curry, in which the school was going to need about $17 million to fund for the renovation. President Curry explained to the students that Northeastern did not have that kind of money ready for when they wanted and needed it most. Once again, the students took it upon themselves. They proposed a second referendum and voted to tax themselves an extra $13.50 per quarter, equaling $50 per semester in order to renovate the center. Two votings took place, and the end result was yes to adding on to the student fee. The trustees approved the $17 million raised for the recommendation by the students, and the students' concepts and ideas were put into reality. President Curry really pushed these students to get their goal. They could not have done what they did without his support and understanding throughout the whole process. The renovation was completed in 6 months, renovating the ground floor in the summer of 1993 and the rest of the building in the summer of 1994. The renovation included a 4,000 square foot glass enclosed eating area known as the West Addition, a diverse food court, a revamped indoor quad, grand staircase, elevator, extra retail outlets, upgraded hallways, media rooms, and artwork. After the renovation of the Student Center was complete, student life really sped up, making the center a much more vibrant and inviting atmosphere. This renovation brought a new vibrancy and functionality to the 30-year-old building, stripping it of its factory feel. President Curry understood the importance of more student involvement, centralized student activities, a community feel, the appreciation of artwork and cultural diversity throughout the university, and helped keep that tradition alive in the Student Center forever. In 1996, after President Curry's retirement, the Student Center was renamed the John A. and Marcia E. Curry Student Center because of all the work and effort he put into making the Student Center what has become for and by the students.
Jack and Marcia, the students extend their sincere appreciation for all that you've done for our Northeastern community. And we want you to know that it is with great pride that forevermore this building will be known as the Curry Student Center. Jack Curry, it had to be you.
What do you think about the fact that all of the Curry renovations were primarily acted upon the students?
I think it's awesome because I think that's what I believe in, the student engagement, because again, as staff, what our vision might be of what programs should be or how a student organization office should be constructed or who we wanted to interact with who. It's not something that, you know, students have to be particular because they're the users of the space. So I think that's what was so exciting.
So I'm Steve. I'm a junior graphic design major here at Northeastern. The show that's opening today is an exhibition of work from our recent Dialogue of Civilizations trip to Venice, Italy. While we were there, we studied photography and art history, and are fortunate enough to have a show, which includes all the work from our trip. Every student is included. For this show, I submitted an application to Gallery 360, which they approved. And after that, I was able to choose the photography that went into the exhibit. I was able to manage the printing and the framing, and lastly, the organization of the photos within the gallery. So all in all, I was very directly involved, and it was a great experience.